Okay, now, somewhere under all this junk, I've got something really old. No, it's not a tape recorder. I just haven't been able to get hold of any of those just lately, but this is something I've had for a very long time. Just trying to clear all the stuff off this so we can take a look. And since it's just fallen down the back of that thing, but never mind, I'll have to dive down there and get it later. I've been needing to do a presentation of this for a while, but I just haven't got round to it, and I just hit the camera, didn't I? Oh well. It's about the best angle I can get the camera on it. Yeah, look at that. It's an antique scalextric. Well, it's not scalextric, but it's a antique racing set. Let's just try to get it better into the camera. I've no idea how old this is, but probably mid, maybe early 60s. Let's take a look under the top, what we have inside. These are the tracks, as you can see. All made out of metal with very sharp edges, so you don't want to make sure you don't cut yourself on that. And this is one of the controllers. There only seems to be one. Don't know where the other one is. Very simple, you've got the two wires coming out the back, and there's a push button to make the cars go. This is actually not variable speed, but it is two speeds. You hold it in a little bit and the cars go slow, and you push it in all the way and the cars go fast. There's, you know, so when you push it in a little way, it connects a resistor, and then all the way, it just connects completely. And these are the cars. This is so old, it's actually made in England. It's not Chinese or Japanese or anything like that. Might be able to see it there if I can just get it in the camera properly. Oh, it's going to blur and glare, isn't it? So I can't really see, but so, that's the cars. There's a lot of other stuff in here too. Not quite sure what these things do. All these come to that matter. I think they're for putting the tracks together. I would love to show you this actually up and running, but well, I just haven't got any room in here to set this thing up. I'm not sure what these things are either. No idea. Anyway, I am going to test the cars, see if they still work. Now, it says on the box 12 volts, so I'm just going to connect up a 9 volt battery and see if the wheels run. It's probably the first time they've been running about goodness only knows how long. Oh, it's not turning. Alright, okay, I just tested that battery and it's as dead as a doornail, so I think that's why these weren't running. Now, I've got a this wire goes to an external power supply. I've set it to 6 volts, which is half of what these take, so let's see if it runs. Oh yes! Sounds a bit spluttery, but it's that one is running. And now I'll see if the red one is working. Ah, yes. Well, it was working. Can't seem to get very good contact, but... yeah. Let's just take a quick close-up of the motors, so you can see them. And can you see that? The motor is actually part of the... by the looks of things, the motor is actually part of the car itself. It's not a separate thing. You can see the brushes and the windings and the magnets as I turn it. About 5-pole motor, that, by the looks of things. Yeah. I think once I clean up the motors in those two cars and find a second controller and power supply, I'll get this set up so you can see it running.